أبو حفص from Bangladesh.
Sheikh, my question is, how should my attitude be towards differences of opinion and towards the opinions that we know that are less, that are not the most authentic opinion? For example, Sheikh, you have taught us that, and I do your taqleed, alhamdulillah, and you have taught us that wearing the niqab is mandatory and that is the most authentic opinion. So Sheikh, I believe that and I adopted that opinion. Now, how should I view you? Look at the opinion that says that it's recommended. Should I think that it's wrong? Like the ones who are doing, they're doing sins?
Okay, I will answer inshallah. Hafs from Bangladesh, he says, what should we do when there is a dispute in opinion among scholars? So for example, we follow the opinion that says niqab is mandatory upon women. How should we treat other people of or who are not abiding by this ruling? They think that it is not mandatory. Well, this is a very easy question. We are not judges. And this is very important. Allah did not send us to label people. You are a fasiq, you are a fajr, you are a hypocrite, you are a kafir, just for the sake of it. There are rooms of difference of opinion, even among the scholars. The Prophet said to them, alayhi salam, do not pray Asr except in Bani Qurayza. So they left Medina, headed to Bani Qurayza. On their way, the sun was about to set. Half of them said, we have to pray, otherwise Asr would expire. Others said, no, the Prophet said, don't pray it until you reach Bani Qurayza. So half of them prayed, the other half didn't. When they reached Bani Qurayza, they told the Prophet ﷺ. He did not say to either party who was doing the right thing, because they did their best. None of the two parties slandered the other for the rest of their lives. Ah, you didn't pray. And the others, oh, you disobeyed the Prophet and you prayed before you reached Bani Qurayza. They all embraced one another's opinions, accepted one another's difference of opinion. And this is how reasonable, intellectual people behave. Those who are like raging bulls, either my way or the highway, if you don't follow what I say, then you are out of Salafiyya, you're out of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. What have I done? Over trivial issues, not issues related to Aqeedah, etc. No, I'm talking about difference of opinion in few things. They are quick to label the other side as Khawarij. And they are quick to label the other side as Murji'ah. And the layman is confusing between who's Muslim, I'm not following this group, and I'm not following this group. So this is what's happening at the moment. No, you have to understand that what you see is right is a possibility to be wrong. And what I see, you think it's wrong, it is a possibility of being right. So we respect other people's choices when it's not related to Aqeedah. Because Aqeedah is not something to differ over. It's fixed from the time of the Prophet ﷺ, Tabi'een and Tabi'at Tabi'een. They all agreed upon it. Anything that comes out of it is deviancy and not part of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. But in fiqh issues, whether you put your hand underneath your belly button or on your chest, or you don't put your hands all together, this is not something that we should fight over. And I respect him, this is what he believes, I respect his opinion, though I believe it's wrong. That doesn't mean I don't give him salam, or I consider him as a renegade from Islam, and Allah knows best.